Hello, my name is Reinhard Meyer. I'm product manager from COPA-DATA. I've been working for the company for 15 years now, and my major jobs are strategic product planning and working together on the R&D projects with our strategic partners. Big data for COPA-DATA means on a larger scale, it's a lot about communication, exchanging data of various types between different business applications, between different platforms. So it's a lot about contribution, networking, bringing data out of different sources altogether. If I break it down a little bit to what our technology can do, we can collect data from production processes, from industries, out of various areas like food and beverage, energy, infrastructure, and pre-process that data and then communicate it with other platforms, for example, ERP systems or any planning systems. COPA-DATA as such is not building a big data application at its own, but we are contributing, as I said, as a kind of communication interface between the different platforms, and we help generating data, harmonizing data for all these different platforms. So what we see is that today there's a lot of more data generated out of various sources, so in the public sector, in the private sector, and of course also in the production processes. And the big challenge for all these projects is bringing these different data types and data sources together to make out of that data good and valid information for better decision making. The second challenge I see is that in the challenge between IT and production, they have different goals. The IT is very much focused on security, is very much focused on maintenance, reliability, and the production processes, they have to run in real time, there's a lot of data generated and they have to be up for 24 hours a day. And the big challenge for all these solutions is bringing these two different goals or target or mindsets together for one big, big data application solution.
My name is Johannes Petrovic, Partner Account Manager at COPA-DATA, and I'm responsible for strategic partnerships and the COPA-DATA partner community. Now I would like to give an example how COPA-DATA can actually contribute to big data applications and smart cities. What we see here on the screen is a map of a city and its surrounding area. In a city, a lot of data is coming together, no matter if it's public transportation, energy, distribution, water, wastewater management, whatsoever. If we have a closer look at the screen, you will recognize the wind parks along the area, on and offshore. Each wind park generating a lot of data, for example, in real time, like wind direction, wind speed. If we combine this real-time data, such as, for example, wind direction, wind speed, with the local traffic management system, it will help the city itself significantly to reduce problems on the roads by, for example, reducing and lowering the speed limits on the roads or even closing bridges. Many experts already talk about machine-generated data being the new currency for enterprises. So what does this specifically mean for private businesses? In the future, if a company, especially in a manufacturing environment, wants to stay competitive in the world of Industry 4.0, it needs to get more out of data it's creating. Important aspects to consider here are machine-to-machine communication, connectivity, user experience, and security. What does it mean for the public sector? As 70% of the world's population will live in cities in 2050, it will be crucial for the public sector to take advantage and take the right decisions of real-time and high-quality data. Only with a great IT infrastructure, the cities will be possible to stay efficient, to stay sustainable, and to make cities a great place for living. Besides the technical requirements, there's still one very important aspect to consider when talking about big data, which is user experience. One of the biggest challenges will be to have flexible staff that can cope with the changing requirements and cope with the tremendous amount of data, having everything under control like a conductor if you want so. So intuitive and ergonomic software will help to increase flexibility and user experience, making perhaps the person the most important factor in the world of tomorrow.